This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is video 8 in our series of solving equations with parentheses. So here's our problem. Feel free to put the video on pause and try it on your own first. See what happens. Okay, so we need to simplify each side of the equation. So just going from left to right here, I have a distributive property to do here first. 2 times 6x is 12x, minus 2 times 5 is 10, then I have the plus 13. And on the right hand side, I have to distribute this negative 3. So let's see, if I do that, I've got the negative 3 times 7, that'll be a minus 21. And I also have a negative 3 times a negative 4x, that'll be a plus 12x. All right, each side is still not simplified because I can combine like terms. So I have 12x plus 3 equals, and on the right hand side I have, well, I've got 15 minus 21, that's negative 6 plus 12x. And if I try to get the variables on one side and constants on the other, how about if I subtract 12x from both sides? So let's see. And how about if I put the variables, the constants on the other side, how about if I subtract 3 from both sides? So I'm going to get what on the left side? I'm going to get just 0, right? Because 12x minus 12x is 0 and 3 minus 3 is 0. But on the right hand side I have negative 9. And this doesn't even make any sense. This is a contradiction. So this original equation, there are no solutions to that. So the answer is the null set, like this, or you could just write in braces. Put nothing inside of it. Now you can't really check this, because the only way to really check is to check it, to make sure really there's no number that you could plug in there to make this true. And of course it's impossible to try every number in the entire world, because you know there's an infinite number amount of numbers. So in this case, when you get something like this, what you might do is just rework the problem again and make sure it really does keep coming up to a contradiction. You know, just make sure you don't make any errors up there. Now, some people might have noticed at this step right here that there was a contradiction. It says 12x plus 3 is really the same thing as 12x minus 6. That doesn't make sense, that if you take something and add 3 to it, you would have the same thing as if you just subtracted 6 from it. So some people might have noticed we've got a contradiction right there. So this is a special case. In video 7, it was a special case. We had an identity where we end up with just a true statement. And now we've come up with a contradiction. That's when you have, there's no variables left. Okay? Notice you just have one number equaling some other number, which is not true. So we call that a contradiction. These are a couple special cases when you're solving equations where you might get something that's always true. It's called an identity, so the solution's all real numbers. Or if you get something that's always false, right? This is always false right there, right? So that means it's a contradiction in terms, and so this is our solution set. These mean the same thing. This circle with a line, this diagonal, does not mean zero. That's not zero. Okay, this is called the null set. In case you haven't seen that, is the null set, or sometimes it's called the empty set, because it means there are no numbers in there at all. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.